in Europe, okay, in other countries in USA, also in other countries in here in Asia. So we are doing this art of network marketing. So this is a very important thing that we need to know in doing the business. Okay, so for those who are listening right now, so you need to listen carefully because even if you're already old or new in the business, this is what you are going to do daily if you want to create a big team in different countries. Okay, so can you type on our comment box if you are now ready to listen to my presentation? Okay, you can type, "I am ready," so that we can check if you are listening. Okay, so now I'm going to start now. So our topic is the art of network marketing. Okay, so this is like what I said a while ago, this is the very basic that we need to learn in doing our business. Okay, if you want to earn big, this is the thing that you need to do daily. So you need to be consistent as well. Okay, so we're going to start with prospecting. Okay, so this is the very basic also, and the first thing that you need to do in the business. Okay, aside from attending training or knowing the business, you also need to do prospecting. Why? Because if you want to create a big team in different countries, okay, if you want to create a big, if you want to build leaders or to have partners in different countries, you also need to look for them in that country. Okay, so I'm going to read what is prospecting. So prospecting, it's a list of names of your friends and relatives or persons that you plan to share the business with. Okay, so when you started this business, okay, you should also have your list of names of people, even that you know, okay, like your friends, your relatives, your coworkers, your what do you call it, your aunt. Okay, so everybody or all the people that are around you, okay, you need to include them as your prospects. Okay, so much better if you have your notebook or if you have your paper, you need to write their names. Okay, so here prospecting is the first step in the sales process, which consists of identifying potential customers or prospects. The goal of prospecting is to develop a database of likely customers and then systematically communicate with them in the hopes of converting them from potential customer to current customer. Okay, so here we have the what we call as the warm market and the cold market. So when we say about warm market, okay, these are the people you know on a first name basis, such as coworkers, friends from the gym, relatives, or etc. Okay, meaning you have a personal connection to them or you are meeting them every day. Okay, so we also have what we call as the cold market. People you met online or the person which is not familiar to you or not likely related to you. Okay, so for example, I am here in the Philippines and I want to expand my business in Ghana, Nigeria, or Liberia. So that is already a cold market because I don't know anybody from that country, but I want to expand or share the business to them or to the people. So I'm using online marketing. Okay, that is the use of the social media sites that we have right now. Okay, so it's very helpful. Okay, so in having our prospect list, or in if we have our prospects, so if you have written your the names of your relatives or your coworkers or the people that you meet every day, okay, you are now going to categorize them. Okay, so you are now going to categorize the people that you meet every day. For example, you have your aunt. Okay, so we have some classifications of people that you meet every day. So we're going to start are the people you know who have authority and money, they can join immediately. Okay, these are the people that for example, they are the principal of a school. Okay, because a principal knows a lot of the, or he holds a lot of people under his organization. Since we have his co-teachers, we have those teachers that are still starting in their work. Okay, So a principal holds the authority to that school. Okay, so if you're going to share the business to them, definitely they have the money. Okay, and if they have the money, they can immediately join in the business if they have understanding. Okay, so we also have the set B. Set B, they are the people who have work or source of income. They have the means to start. Okay, meaning they are the teachers, nurse, okay, doctors, policemen, okay, managers. Okay, these are the people that you know that are working. Okay, so that whenever you share the business to them, they are going to join you because they have a source of income or they have a source of income where they can get their capital in the business. Okay, so we also have here letter C. It's our last priority. You know who can't afford to start yet. Okay, so these are the people that sometimes, but this they are actually the people that are also successful in the business that we are doing. Sometimes we judge people based on their current situation right now. For example, if you saw your friend or if you saw someone, he doesn't have any, he doesn't have work or he doesn't have any source of income, but he's looking for an opportunity. And sometimes you are judging them that, oh, this person, he can't do the business or he can't provide the capital for his registration in the business. Okay, sometimes you do that in our everyday prospecting. Okay, but we should always remember that sometimes those people that we are neglecting, they are the ones who are becoming leaders and they are the ones becoming successful in the business. So I know everybody here, we have a lot of, or we heard a lot of testimonies of people in doing this business before they were a trotro driver, okay? Before they are a trotro driver, but right now they are global ambassador or part of the millionaire circle in the business. Before they are street vendors, but in the business, they are now, or when they join the business, they are now millionaire circle, global ambassador, they can even travel anywhere, okay? So we should always consider those people that we think they don't have anything, but if we share the business to them, they understood it, they have seen the vision that we have also seen, okay? They're going to find a way, and then they can register in the business, okay? We don't know what our people thinking. We don't know what people think. So we need always to share the people to everybody. Okay? Everybody or anybody that we can meet along the way. Okay? Much better if we will not become judgmental to our prospects or to our clients. Okay? So you also need to write their names. So if you have known someone that you think you know him personally and you know for a long time he doesn't have any permanent job or he doesn't have any work, you still need to include him and share the business with him. Okay? You need to write him on your prospect list. Okay? So, yeah, I have sample there. Okay? So, you can see there, we have written some names of our prospect. And then, we put some division. Okay? So, we put there, if we have already approached that person, because sometimes, if we are not writing the names of those persons that we share the business, sometimes we are neglecting them, okay? So you are meeting them every day, but you didn't approach the business to them. So much better, all your prospects or all the persons that you know, you're going to write them on your notebook, and then you are going to check if you have already shared the business to them or not yet, if you have already approached them or not yet, okay? Or after you approach them, did you already share to them about the business or you just only talk nonsense things to them, okay? So after you have invited them or after you have invited them, you need also to share the business to them. So we have there the OPP or the opportunity plan presentation. And you can also write there or you can check there if you have or they have the exact date when they are going to join in the business. Okay, so much better. That is the best thing that you need to do every day to have a complete list of your prospects so that you can neglect everyone, okay? Because sometimes the more people that we are talking every day, sometimes those people that we have shared before, we are not already communicating with them because we don't know or we forgot their names on Facebook or even we forgot their names on the list. Okay, so much better we have a complete list of our prospects. So this is very important as well. Okay. Okay, so now I'm going to teach you on how, or I'm going to show you some of the things that we are doing on how we find Facebook on, or with how we find prospects on Facebook. Okay, so here I have shown you on a picture. You can see there, you can actually find prospects on Facebook based on their names and their countries. For example, if you are starting right now and you want to build a team in Ghana, okay, since that is what we have, that is what we are seeing in the screen. So, for example, you want to start, or you want to start a network in that are common in Ghana, you can actually search that on Google. Okay, you can use your Google. You can search the common names that are given in a person in every country. There are that. You can check that on Google. Okay. For example, Benjamin from Ghana. Okay. So we have typed there on our search box on Facebook. You can type there Benjamin from Ghana. Okay. So all the names that coming from Ghana, that name Benjamin, you can have there in the suggestion box. Okay. So from that one, you can now already choose who are you going to add as your friend, or who do you think is your potential prospect that when you share the business to them, they are going to join in the business. Okay. You need also to be very careful. Okay. Not that you have seen a list of names in the suggestion box and you have added them all. Okay, you need also, you can check their profile. If this person is already a graduate, or he is working, or he is very young, okay, because definitely if they are young, they are not yet still earning, they don't have any source of income to join in the business. Okay, so you can check on their profile. As you can see here on our sample, so on the first one, okay, the profile, on the second one, the third, on the fourth one, he is wearing a suit. Okay, so definitely he's a little, he have a work. Okay, but you can check more on their profile or on their timelines, the things that they are posting there. Okay, so don't just randomly add people because you think they are from Ghana. Okay, be careful in adding your prospects. Much better if you are going to add your prospects little by little, or 10 every day, or 20 every day, as long as you know they are very potential to join in the business. Okay, they have the potential to join. Okay, not that if you are adding 50 persons per day, but they are not a potential customer in the business. Okay, you can do it little by little. Okay, we also have here friends of friends. Okay, meaning friends of friends. If you have already your friends from Ghana, you could actually check on his friends. Okay, you can click there, see all the friends, and then from that, you can now choose whom you are going to add to be your prospects. Okay? There are a lot of friends. If you have two or three friends, they have already a different, they have already a lot of friends already that you can choose from. Okay. So aside from friends of friends, you can actually also join group page. Okay? Since we have a lot of group page on Facebook, you could actually search there. Policemen from Ghana. So there are some also that have group page for that position or for that kind of work. Okay, or nurses or doctors organization from Ghana. Okay, from those pages, you can choose, or you can, for example, they have posted something there, and then you can check there on what those who have liked or put emoticons on the picture or those postings that have posted there, then you can add them on your, or they can, you could send requests to them. Okay. You can add on group pages. You can have, or you can look for prospects on fan page. Okay. Fan page. Okay. We have also on timelines of your prospects or your friends. You can check there those who have commented or those who have, set emojis, okay, or those who are active on their profile or on their timeline, those who are commenting or something like that. Okay, so we have a lot of different ways on how you can do prospecting, okay? Especially on online. You can also use your Twitter if you have your Twitter, okay? You can use that for prospecting. You can use your WhatsApp. Those persons that you have saved on your WhatsApp, you can use that one also, not only on Facebook, okay? We have also some on dating sites, okay? Those who are using that one, you could actually also use that one. It's very, okay? So that is some of the ways on how you can find your prospects online, okay? So now, after you have sent friend request to them, you are now going to invite them in the business. Okay, so we're now going to proceed to the second one, which is inviting. This is simple by applying the form. Okay, we need to have conversation with our prospect by knowing the right information. Okay, sorry, I'm going to take break. Okay, so we need to use the form in inviting people on Facebook, especially if we met friends on Facebook. Okay, we need first to have a conversation with them. Okay, how do you find or how are you going to use form? So F stands for family. Okay, so for example, you have added someone on Facebook. You could actually directly send them a message. For example, for me, what I'm doing is, hi, thanks for connecting me here on Facebook. I hope you are doing good. So you are from what country? Or how is your family? So since we're going to start with F, okay? Or familia, or country, the one that I'm asking first when I'm having conversation for them is, you are from what country, okay? So that I would know if they are from Liberia, if they are from Ghana, or something like that. Okay, so you can ask that as your, after that, you can ask, they are from Liberia. So you can ask them, how is your family? How is everyone doing? How is your sister? Okay, because definitely if you're asking for that one, sometimes you have some prospects that are saying, oh, my father is sick. Okay, or he is in the hospital. My mother is having diabetes or high blood, or he's having cancer. Okay, they are going to open up some of the problems that they have in their family. Okay, letter O stands for occupation. Okay, you can ask them, oh, what are you doing for a living there in your country? Some others, they are saying, I'm a doctor, I'm an engineer, okay, I'm a minor, okay? So that is what they are saying when you ask about their profession, so that you would definitely know, or you are already going to know, if they have the source of income, or they have the means to register in a business. Because sometimes you are talking to people, they would say, oh, I don't have, or I'm not doing anything. Okay, so definitely you don't have any source of income. So if you're going to share the business to them, you are just only going to waste your time, because he doesn't have any source of income that he is going to use to register in the business. And sometimes, okay, what they are doing is they are asking you for money. Okay. So you need to know what occupation they are doing or what work is he doing in that country, okay? So after that, after asking about their occupation, you could actually ask them also about R, that is for recreation. So recreation meaning you can ask them what they are doing after their work, okay? So are they just only watching TV or are they only traveling? Are they, you could actually ask them about that, okay? So some others are saying they're watching TV after work, or they are tired or something like that, okay? So from that one, if you have already asked about their family, their occupation, and their recreation that they are doing after work, then you can now start with the message, okay, or the presentation. So as we have seen here, by knowing the right information, if you have already know the right information, okay? Okay, so the main purpose is for us to know the specific needs of our prospects. So That is the reason why we need to use the form, okay? Okay, so by using form, you can identify if their family needs the product. Okay, so like what I mentioned a while ago, if you have asked about their family, they can say that their family or their father is in the hospital or their father is sick, okay? Then you know already when you present the business, you focus on the products because our products are good, okay? It has a lot of testimonies already that they have been cured from their diseases. So you can share it to them. Okay, so also if they need break from their work, okay, if their current work is stressing them, then you can actually share the business to them. Okay, so you can focus on the benefits if they join in the business, that when they join the business, they can travel. Okay, if they are already earning big, they can travel anywhere. They even if they are sleeping, they can be earning in the business. Okay. Or if they want more on financial aspects. So if they have mentioned a while ago that their salary is not helping them, okay, it is lacking or they have shortage of money or financial, then you can share about to them on how they can earn in the business like most of us are having despite this pandemic. Okay, that's a good thing about the business that we are doing. So even if you have this kind of pandemic because of AIM Global or Empowered Consumerism that we are doing, we are still earning, okay? Because most of those people right now, because of the pandemic, there are a lot of people who lose their jobs, okay? When you are talking, I encounter people online. They are saying, because of the COVID-19, I don't have any work right now, so I'm not doing anything, okay? So that means they are lacking on financial aspects already, because they don't have anything to support their expenses every day as well as their family, the needs of their family. So you can share to them about financial aspect that when they join in the business, they are going to earn, okay? And if they are already earning, they can provide the needs for their family, okay? So after that one, and on what they love to do, like travel, gatherings, and bandings. So there are some people that we meet, they have already their stable job, they have already their finances, but they can travel. Or they can't go anywhere. They can't go bandings because they are banded to the work. Okay? Although financial is not the problem, since they have their work, but they don't have any time to travel, gatherings, or bandings. So that's the time already that you can share the business to them that, you know, when you are going to do this business 2 to 3 years from now, okay, you're going to go or you can travel anywhere, you can attend gatherings of your people or your family, okay, without worrying if you're going to earn in your job or not. Because in the business, it's already given that if you created a big team in the business and you are earning, okay, even if you are not there to support your team, they are still continuously going to do it. And even if you are sleeping or even traveling, going outside the countries, you are still earning in the business. Okay, so you need to be specific on the things that you need to explain to them, to your prospects. You need to get the right information from them first. And then after that one, that's the time that you connect what they need in the business. So that those people that you have shared or that you have talked about the business, they will definitely join in the business. It doesn't matter if they're going to join because they like the products. If their family is having sickness or something like that, some of their family members, it doesn't matter if they're going to join because they want to have financial independence, okay? Or if they want to travel or anything, okay? As long as you get the right information from them, okay? So we can deliver the exact and appropriate message to them. So that is what I'm saying a while ago. So if you have already right information, you can definitely get them to register in the business. Because what you explain to them is what they needed right now to break free from their work or to break free from their charge of money. Okay? Upon knowing what they need, you can now proceed with the presentation. So after inviting them or knowing their problems, you can now start with your presentation, okay? So we have different kinds of presentation in the business that we are doing. Okay, so first, office or online presentation using WhatsApp or Messenger. So most of our international partners are using WhatsApp and Messenger. So if you want to present the business easily or faster, well, if you're going to send a script, much better you're going to use WhatsApp. Okay, for those who wants to start international marketing, okay? Or you can actually also use Messenger, but it is slower compared if you're going to use WhatsApp, okay? So we have different kinds of presentations. So we're going to start with one-on-one presentation or table talk presentation where you can present it immediately with one or three clients, okay? So I think there is Okay, one-on-one presentation or table talk presentation, okay? So sometimes you have prospects that they only have, for example, 15 minutes or they have only 10 minutes to listen to you, okay? So you don't need to bring them anymore in the office just to present the business. So you need to, you yourself, you need to present it to her or to your prospect immediately. You just need to have your ballpen and your paper, okay? And then you explain the business to him, okay? Because like what I mentioned, if he is in a hurry, okay, he doesn't have a lot of time to listen to your presentations and he doesn't have any time to meet some of your clients or sponsors, then you need to be the one to present the business to him or to her. So it is very important that when you join in the business, you need to learn on what are the benefits of the products, what are the things that we can get or how we can earn in the business, so that if you met a person that who wants to join in the business and he wants to learn the business immediately, you can explain it to him. Okay, so that is one-on-one presentation. So you can just sit face-to-face and then you can present the business already. Okay, so we also have here where you can present it immediately with one or three clients, okay? So it is one or three clients, so it's not crowded if you have one or three clients. So next, you also have home meeting presentation. You can visit your clients or make schedule to visit them, okay? So in doing presentation, you can actually ask your friends or your relatives to conduct or to gather people in a place or in their home, and then you can go there and do the home presentation. Okay, so it doesn't matter if how many people are there as long as you are the one who went or to visit them, because they can't go directly in the office to attend the trainings. Okay, so that is also very important. Like what I said, you need to learn everything about the business. You don't need to depend on your upline every time. Okay, like what most of our top earners are saying, your success doesn't lie on your upline, okay? It lies on your own hands. So you need to learn the business as quickly as possible, okay? So next, we also have here, big presentation is a big gathering of all your invites in a presentation office or area, okay? So you could actually invite all your friends, okay? All your relatives, or you can have a flyer ring, okay? And then you can do, or you can set a date, when are you going to do or conduct the presentation, okay? And then you can share the business to your people already. Actually done by one of my business partner from Tamale, okay? Since we don't have our office there, so my business partner there learned about the business, okay? He learned it on himself, so he's actually mute and deaf. I don't communicate with him on a normal video call, okay? So if I am talking to him, he have a interpreter since he can't talk or he can't hear me, okay? So, but you see on the screen, he is having a business presentation to his prospects, okay? That is actually a deaf community. So he's using sign language to present the business. So you should be inspired to him, okay? If you are watching right now and you are not yet doing the business, you need to be inspired with him, because he is deaf, he is mute, but he is actually, he have already actually earned almost 600 Ghana cedi in his account. Okay, so he have already 4 leaders under his organization. Okay, so be inspired, because how could a deaf person or a mute person share the business to people? Okay, so that is just only one of my business partner from Tamale. Okay, so I have also here another business partner. So that is what I'm saying a while ago. He is actually one of our speakers. We are already in Ghana, especially are based in Kumasi. Okay, so he actually conducted a big presentation in a school that is almost over 7,200 audience, including the teachers, including the students. Okay, so he conducted a business presentation to a large crowd of people. Okay, so you could actually organize something like that, but that is done not yet pandemic. Okay, because maybe you were thinking that is done during the pandemic, so that is done not yet pandemic. Okay, but you could actually do that one in your area, especially if your area is already clear with the pandemic. You can organize your people. If you have already your team of people, then you need to connect with them. Okay, so we're going to set a date. We need to have a presentation in this area. So you need to gather people. You need to inform your relatives or your friends, your coworkers to attend the presentation. Okay, so you could actually do that one also there in wherever you are. So this is from Ghana, okay? Our business partner from Ghana. Okay, so we also do have online presentation. You can easily share the business information through videos or business scripts via Facebook Messenger, WhatsApp, or any social media applications. Okay, that is actually very common to all of us today. Okay, because right now, this pandemic doesn't allow us to go out. Okay, it hinders us to meet people outside. So what we are using is online presentation. So if you doesn't yet know how to do online presentation, you need to consult or you need to ask your upline how he is doing online presentation. Okay, you need to be very resourceful. You need to ask always upline on how do you do this. So this is very important to our network today, because this is booming already. Okay, we have a lot of business partners that are earning a lot in online. Okay, so we need to adapt on this platform also. Okay, so like what I said a while ago, you can use your Facebook Messenger. Okay, you can share the business to people anywhere in the world. Okay, it doesn't matter if he's a Muslim or he's a Christian. It doesn't matter if he is from other religions. Okay, as long as he is willing to know about the business, then we need to share it to them. Okay, we should not be picky on those people that have commented on our Facebook, oh, this person, he is from that place or he is from that place. I don't like to present the business to him. Okay, you doesn't know who is the person who's going to join your team and who is the person who's going to make you rich in the business. Okay, so the person that I showed a while ago, so mentor Amino Yakubu from Ghana. So when I first met him on online, okay, since I'm based here in the Philippines, when I first met him on online, okay, so I thought that I'm having conversation with RC. He have already a big team also in Ghana and part of the Speakers Europe. Okay, that is what is happening if we are doing or sharing. So that is for the online presentation. If you don't have the scripts or you don't know how to present it, then you need to compare or you need to ask your upline to give you the details. Okay, since every country we do have presentation. If we have our branch office there, we have the package that is available in that country. But if we don't have any office there, we are using the US dollar sponsors for that presentation, or you can connect them to your sponsors. Okay, just look for people, then connect them directly to your sponsor. That's easy. Okay, for you, that is what you're going to do. Just connect people to your sponsor, and your sponsor will be the one to present it for you, and you will have your team in different countries already. Okay, so you need to work with your sponsor. But don't rely on your sponsor, okay? That whenever you're go, that whenever have new prospects is going to put under your team, and you're just only waiting for it. You need to work it out also if you want to earn big in the business, okay? So next, you must learn to do the presentation very well, okay? So if you are just only starting in the business, you need to attend trainings, okay? We have a lot of trainings online. If you are from Nigeria, we have our AIM Nigeria Talks, okay? We have PGS for that one. We also have, for Ghana, we have AIM Ghana Talks, okay? So that is the pages that you can look, okay? And then for other pages, I think for other countries, we have some of the pages also that we are having. And I think for every team, we also have presentations, okay? Or if you don't know yet, or if there is no presentation or trainings that you can see on Facebook, then you need to connect with your upline to teach you on how to do the presentation in your country. Okay, the currency, the packages, and everything about the business, okay? You should have the willingness to learn the business, because if you are a person who is very keen to ideas or to learn everything, then it would be easier for you to learn it, and it would be easier for you to present it also to people in your area. Okay, see how opportunity can help them solve. We said a while ago, if you met a person having diabetes, then present the business about the product to them. Okay, that when they, since you have already a lot of testimonies regarding that one. If they are having financial problems, then you can show some testimonies of our top earners that are already earning big in the business. Okay, before there was something, they don't have anything, they were broke, but because they do the business right now, they are earning big. So if you could also address their problems, because that is what they are facing also today. Okay, so that's it. And number four, closing. So ending presentation by making your prospect realize the importance of what have been discussed at your press, online or online. Okay, if you are talking to your prospect, after you present the business to them, after you present the marketing plan or the product presentation, after you present it, you need to ask your prospect what if he have any questions about the business that you have presented, or did he understand everything? Or did he have some doubts or something like that? To have first conversation with your, okay? Because sometimes after a presentation, we normally ask, oh, okay, when are you going to join? They don't understand, but they didn't understand the presentation that we did. Okay, or they have their doubts, but because you didn't ask that question, they didn't ask it, and the reason why they didn't join in the business, because so in doing the closing, much better, everything is clear, okay, all their questions have been answered, and then after that time, that's the time that you're going to ask, when are they going to join in the business? Are you going to register today? Are you going to send your payment today? Or are you going to deposit your payment today in Ecobank or in Consolidated Bank of Ghana, in Zenith Bank, okay, or any other banks that they are using in different countries? Okay, you need to ask them if they can do it today, or if they can do it today, or can you do it tomorrow? Or if they said, oh, I can't do it tomorrow. Okay, then can you do it next week, Monday, Tuesday next week, Thursday next week, or you can do it month and March, February 28th or February 27th. Okay, if you can make it specific, that would be much better, so that you would know when are you going to follow up on them, okay? So don't forget to ask if they are going to join now, because sometimes we neglect to ask if they're going to register now. Register now. For example, if you think about the business, but the thing that you didn't ask is when is he going to join or is he going to join now? Okay, and he was thinking since he have already his money on his pocket, and yet you didn't ask, he's not going to give it to you or he's not going to deposit it to the bank because you didn't ask of it. Okay, we have prospects like that. And we also have prospects that when you say or after you present the business, after you talk to them over the phone or you talk to them personally, they are going to go to the bank immediately and they registered. I think I have two persons who did that to me. I just talked to them in the morning about the business, and then the afternoon, they already deposited their payment in the banks. Instant registrations. Okay, so we have prospects that are doing that one. Since they realize or they have understand the business that we presented to them. Okay, so you could actually do that one. There's nothing wrong in asking when they are going to join, because if they have their money right now, they are going to deposit it to the bank. Okay, I experienced that personally with some of my leaders from Ghana. So I've talked to them in the morning about the business, discussed to them, and then in the afternoon or after how many minutes or after how many hours, they already sent their payment. Okay, so that's very powerful in doing the closing. Okay, so next we're going to proceed and also help them see how to solve their problems and their needs. Okay. Get them to meet with the time that they are ready to join. So that is what I'm explaining a while ago. You can ask if they're going to register today, tomorrow, Tuesday, month end. Okay, because most of them, they're saying after I got my salary. So that would be month end or on the 15th day. Okay, so push them, but don't be too pushy to cause them to become offended. Okay, so you just only need to ask them. You don't need to say, oh, this month you need to join. You need to do it. Okay, just ask them when they are going to join. Okay, you can also use the ABC rule. So what's ABC rule? So A stands for advisor, B stands for bridge, and C stands for client. So A is for your for your uplines or your sponsors or those persons that you know that are already earning in the business. B is for bridge, that is you. C is for the client. Okay, that's it. C is for the client. Okay, so you need also to let your clients talk to your sponsor or to those who are persons that you know that are already earning in the business. Because sometimes, okay, if you are just only the one communicating with your prospects, okay, they will not listen to you, especially if they know you personally or they know you since when you are young. Okay, definitely they're going to believe in you. But if you're going to use a third person that is going to discuss everything about a business or is going to testify that when he joined in the business he's already earning a lot, okay, can actually show testimony, something like that, and then definitely that person will also be inspired, your client will also be inspired, then he can join in the business, not because of you but because of the person that you have let him talk with. Okay, so you could actually do that one. So it is very important that when you go to the office, if you are near in the office there, you could actually meet a lot of top earners. Okay, you can communicate with them, you can introduce yourself to them that I'm just only new in the business but I want to get tips from you, and then even going to do that for you. Okay, so you don't rely on your sponsor only. You could actually do that to other teams as well. Okay? So that is how powerful ABC rule is. Most of our partners are earning, are joining, or those who are upcoming business partners are joining because of ABC rule. They are inspired on the person that you have introduced them to. Okay? So advisor is usually the sponsor or anybody who had more experience in the business that have big results. There are car achievers, global ambassadors, millionaire circle, or travel qualifier, or any other achievements that they have in the business. So your part is very essential for you to close the deal. All you need to do is a bridge, is to connect the client to the advisor by means of building up your advisor, okay? You should also remember that as you, the role that you have is to let your prospect know your sponsor, okay, or the advisor. Don't introduce your sponsor, don't introduce your client to your sponsor that this person or my client is a doctor or something like that. Much better you talk to your prospect and inform him, oh, my sponsor is already a millionaire circle, global ambassador in the business. So definitely if you are going to learn to him, then if you're going to listen to him, you are also going to earn big in the business like him. Okay, so that's also the thing that we need to keep in mind if we're going to do the ABC rule. Okay, so build the achievements of your sponsor to your clients. Okay, not the other way around. See, our client is surely will surely listen and will take all the advices. Okay, so it doesn't matter what is the profession of your prospects, as long as you have build a good relationship with your sponsor and your clients is going to listen to your sponsor. Okay? Remember always the advisor to the clients. So because if you're going to introduce our clients to our sponsor, you said to your sponsor, oh, my client is a doctor, he's holding or he's having a lot of people under his organization, so he's also a cum laude or salutatory or something like that. Okay, so of course your sponsor will also be intimidated if you're going to do that one. So much better always discuss or always share the achievements of your sponsor to your clients, okay? It doesn't matter what their profession is. Okay, so number five, so this is actually the last one that we need to do, and this is very important. Why? Because I have experience also from this one, just doing follow-up to your prospects. It didn't mean that when you present the business, those persons are going to join us immediately. Okay, there are some people that are going to say, oh, I'm going to join next month. I'm going to join on month end. It's just only starting. The month is just only starting. And he mentioned he's going to join on month end. He's going to get his salary. Or though there are those people that are not saying when they are going to join since they don't know where they are going to get their money to join in the business. But because of doing follow-up, okay, always use the 24 to 48 hour rule. So this is actually after you do the presentation, you could actually follow up on them about the business that you presented. Okay, but when they say already the exact date, okay, make follow up to your clients within 48 hours after seeing the business presentation. So that is actually, you could actually ask them, how is the business that I shared to you? Okay, you can actually ask them about that one, and then when they're going to join. Okay, so what are the things that you need to do when you are doing follow-up to your client? So like what I mentioned a while ago, this is very important to your prospects. Okay, especially if you have a lot of prospects, you need to follow up on them all. Okay, so you can send videos of successful stories or make a call from time to time. Send your updates like your daily business transactions. So actually in doing follow-up, yeah, you could actually send successful stories, successful testimonies. Okay, we have a lot of that on Facebook or on YouTube. You just need to download those videos. Okay, you could actually also make a call from them, but that doesn't mean that when you call them, you are going to ask about the business immediately. Okay, you can actually make a short conversation. For example, how's your family today? Or what did you do today? Did you eat already your lunch? Or did you eat already your dinner? Okay, or are you out from your work? Okay, you could actually discuss outside, why do you need a business? But when you're talking to them, definitely they're going to put in mind, or they will remember the business that you have presented to them. Okay, you can also send your updates like your daily business transactions. For example, if you receive money because you have a new business partners, or if you have bought packages in the office with your team, you could actually send that as an update to them, to your prospects. Okay? So, yeah, like that. So, you need to do this. Okay. So, you need to do this daily or any other day. Okay, after 2 days or after 3 days, okay? But don't do it for a longer time, okay? Because you need also to... Okay, so you need to... Wait, someone is calling me. Who's that? Okay, anyway, we're back. Can you hear me clear? Can you type?
Yes, coach. Yes,
coach. It's already loud?
Yes, please.
Is it loud already? Okay. So, no. Sorry.
Loud and clear.
Someone is calling me, one of our prospects from international. Okay. Anyway, I'm going to finish it already. So make follow-up to your clients within 48 hours after seeing the business presentation. So like what I mentioned, you can do, or you can send your daily transactions to them or anything. Okay, even the food that you are eating, you could actually do that one. You can invite them, because we have some prospects that sometimes when you are doing video call or when you are talking to them, and then sometimes they were saying, oh, why didn't you invite me in while you were eating? Okay. So I have experienced most of the time of that for our international partners. Okay, you're not inviting me when you are eating, something like that. Okay? So that's it on follow-up. Okay, hi, Jeremiah. Ayan. Okay, so that is how you do follow-up, because sometimes the persons that we are follow-upping, it doesn't matter if you have prospects that it takes 3 months, 6 months, or 9 months, or even after 1 year, they're going to join you in the business because you keep follow-upping on them. Okay, for me personally, I have met a lot of partners that are joining after 5 months or after 6 months. They are just only prospects that are observing you. Okay, they are observing your daily transactions to them, and then they will be inspired from you. Sometimes you would hear from them, oh, I'm inspired with you. Why? Because even after a year that you have presented the business to me, you are still consistent that you are doing follow-up on me. Okay, so that is very important why you need at first to write the names of your prospect. Okay, we're going to start with the prospect list, because you can't follow up your prospect if you don't have your prospect list. Right? You are talking to a lot of people every day. You keep on presenting the business to people every day. You can present the business 30 people a day. Then after 3 months, how many people have you already presented? Okay, it would take, if you didn't write their names on your prospect list. Okay, it would be hard for you. And even if they have already their money, but you didn't follow up on them, they're not going to join your team, or they're not going to join you. And sometimes we have some have presented to them, but they don't have any contact with them already. Okay, because they didn't do already follow up. They forgot about them. So sometimes they are joining our team, although we just only shared to them the business. We just only shared the business in a few minutes. Okay, so that is how powerful follow up is. You need to be, it will take 6 months, 1 year, because definitely those people that are follow upping will also join during that year. If they have already the money, they will always remember you to join in the business. Okay, so you can like that, and then this will maintain the excitement at their part. So if you keep on follow-upping on them, definitely they will also be excited to join in your business. Okay? Because if you're not talking to them anymore after you presented the business to them, definitely they will also forget you. Okay, they will forget the business that you have presented to them. So you need always to follow up on them so that they will be excited still to join in the business. Okay, and don't hesitate to always ask if they are convenient and ready to join within the day already. Okay, so from time to time, but not all the time, you can ask them, oh, are you now ready to join in the business? Or when are you now going to join in the business? Okay, you could actually ask that also, but not always. Okay, so 12 trial and tested recruitment techniques. Okay, so I think I'm not going to discuss that anymore. Okay, so that is, okay, so that is the basic five fingers of network marketing that we are doing. Even now, even we have our team in different countries, even if I have my team or I have my speakers bureau under my team, I'm still continuing to doing the five fingers of network countries. Okay, so you just need to apply what you have learned today and do it. Okay, so that you can also be the next with your team, not only here in the Philippines, you can expand it in this world. Okay, so thank you very much. And I'm going to give it back to the host already. Coach Annie. Be the last one standing, two hands in the air. I'm a champion. You'll be looking up at me when it's over. I live for the battle. Yes. Wow. Thank you. Thank you from Beth Holland for the very wonderful presentation of our beauty of our business. So I hope and I know that everyone who is here with us tonight, especially to those partners who are already member, got refreshed with the topic, with the marketing that Coach Faye or Prof Faye just discussed. All right. And of course, to those partners who are just a beginner, I know that you have absorbed a lot of learnings today. And if you want to be one of those people that she presented a while ago in her presentation, then you should definitely follow and practice this presentation that she just discussed us. Okay, so it's not gonna be easy, but if you keep on practicing it daily, okay, as she said that you should do it consistent, then definitely you will get a result and you will be one of those very successful in this business. So again, we're all done here. Thank you very much for being with us here tonight. And to those partners who are watching us on live, hello, hello. So I cannot mention you all, but I would like to say thank you very much. And you can keep on watching this over and over and over so that you will learn more. Okay, so that's all. We're all done here. Thank you very much, Coach Faye. And I hope to see you again here in the Top 6 Millionaires. And God bless everyone. Anytime. Anytime.
God bless.
Okay, thank you, everyone. See you again.